I am Reverend Vimalajyoti Ratwita. I live in this Cambodian Buddhist temple, Modesto. He is my chief incumbent in this temple. He is Venerable Ying Soong. Both we are living in this Cambodian temple. Thank you very much inviting us to give a little speech about Buddhism. Origin of Buddhism. Buddha born in India in 6th century BC. It means 2600 years ago, Buddha born in India, the place called Lumbini. Now it is belongs to the Nepal. In that time, there is a lot of kinds of religions. People, they are practicing many kinds of religions. The Buddha image, Buddha emerged and he gave the new life of religions to the people. He preached to the non-Buddhists. All the people who come to him, he preached what is good, what is bad. That is the main thing in Buddhism. One time, one monk who went on the almsgiving, the man asked, "What Buddha teach?" He said, "Buddha teach what is arise," and he tell us the what is the cause of the reason why it arise. That is what we call Buddhism. And as a summary, we can say the Buddhism: sabba papassa akaranam kusalassa upasampada sacitta pariyodappanam etam buddha anusasana. It means Buddha's advice not to do bad thing, do the good things, and steadily calm your mind. That is the main Buddhist teaching. Reincarnation. Actually, in Buddhism, we don't believe reincarnation. It's we call not even the rebirth. We call the punabhava. Punabhava means the person, me, if I die, I will be born another place. But the rebirth or reincarnation is the me I died and born in another place, same as me. Because it is in Buddhism not like that. Buddhism, I die, I will be reborn according to the things I have done in this very life. So I will be born another place and I have to suffer according to my previous karma. So nobody will suffer my karma. I have to reborn, or the whatever you call rebirth or incarnation. So that two word is actually not Buddhism. Buddhism mean the real, the Pali word punabhava. It mean born in another place, not the same, not the another, not the same person, not the another. So I have to suffer what I did. So you have to suffer what you did. So I cannot take your action. You cannot take my action. So Buddhism is good and bad. So whatever we do, we have to suffer. Buddha said, he cannot put me into hell. He cannot put me into heaven. So I have to go to heaven myself. I have to go hell myself. Buddhist people, they have some ceremonies and they have rituals. And mostly if somebody born and marriage and death, all those ceremonies, they invited monks. If somebody is we go to the pregnant women's, when they invited, we do some chanting for them, protecting chanting. And when somebody want to get married, the monks, go there and they do the chanting, blessing chanting for the both bride and bridegroom. And if somebody passed away, they have rituals more than the other times. Especially if somebody passed away within 3 days, they ask the monks to come and chanting. And sometimes 7 days, sometimes 1 month, and after 100 days. So they do and call the monks, and they give the dana, and they do the blessings, and they listen to the Dhamma talk, and do lot of meritorious deeds, and they transfer the merit to departed soul. That is normally what our Buddhist people is doing. Buddhist people has some moral codes. Normal world people, they have 5 precepts. The first one is Panatipata, not killing. The second one is Adinnadana, not stealing. The third one is sexual misconduct. The fourth one is not having intoxicating drink. The fifth one is lying. These 5 basic things, if you protect, that sort of society will be very peaceful. The people, then it means we respect each other. If you are not killing, if you are not stealing, if you have not doing any sexual misconduct, not drinking alcohols, not stealing or lying. So then what will happen? The society, we protect by ourselves. No need some other parties to protect us. If we all protect these 5 codes, it will be, if there is a good society in anywhere, any society will be the good society because we protect ourselves. I think that is the good moral codes for the not only the Buddhists, everybody in the world. The role of the women, it is very essential. Buddha never discriminate the woman. Woman has the same right as the man. Once Buddha explained, the woman also has the ability to, according to the time and occasion, she will be also wise. Not only the man will be the wise, woman also the wise. Not all the time man is wise, woman also wise according to the time. So woman roles normally in our society, Buddha society, we explain bhikkhuni. Bhikkhu mean male, bhikkhuni mean female. Upasaka, upasika. Upasaka mean the man or the lay people, and upasika mean lay women. Man can become a monk and woman can become a nun. Buddha's time, there is a lot of mahatheris. As Mahatheras and Mahatheris, lot of Mahatheris who enlightened ones. So even nowadays we have Bhikkhu Bhikkhuni and Upasaka Upasika. So everybody can become Buddha. And Buddha says, not even other religions. In Buddhism, anybody can become a Buddha. You need your works, and you have to work hard for that and do what should be fulfilled. Then one day you can become the Buddha. Buddhism is actually is a practical religion. Anybody can criticize, anybody can question the Buddha. You can ask question, you can read. Buddhism is for the wise people. Buddha says, ehi pasika mean come and see. Anybody can come and see, you can read, you can learn, you can question. If you question, you can understand. If you are listening to the Buddha or if you are listening to the Dhamma, you have problem, you have to question that. Then you can go ahead. So Buddhism means everybody, and you can question it. Then it is open for anybody in the world. Thank you very much for listening to this talk.